Mobile is ready to set sail. The USS Jackson, a littoral combat ship, or LCS, was christened this morning at Austell, USA. Fox 10 News reporter Katie Wise went down to the Mobile River to explore the funding controversies surrounding these types of ships.
With one strong swing of a champagne bottle, the Navy's first ship named after Jackson, Mississippi was christened.
I was nervous. I was hopeful that I would be able to smash it on the first try, and luckily that's what happened.
The USS Jackson is a littoral combat ship, also known as an LCS. It's a long-standing program promoted by the Navy. But recently, it's seen some cuts. An original naval contract with the U.S. government was going to build some 52 of these LCSs, but Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel recently cut that to 32, and this USS Jackson is one of those on that bill. Senator Jeff Sessions explains his concerns about the future.
So the talk is, should we continue beyond the 32 or not? We want to be able to make sure that we communicate to every congressman and every senator, and I know Congressman Byrne agrees with this totally, why this is important, why it's cost effective, why the Navy has made this a priority for almost 18 years, because it's lighter, faster, more flexible, with more capability, and less expensive to build and operate.
Congressman Bradley Byrne tells me that a couple months ago he was a little skeptical about the future of the LCS ships, but he says now he's seeing a bright future for the LCS program.
Are you concerned at all that this could be one of the last LCSs to be christened?
I was more concerned a couple months ago than I am now. I think we're in the right direction. I think what we're going to end up with is a modified version of this ship after we build the first 32.
Secretary of the Navy Ray Mabus says the LCS program could go one of three ways. It could stay on its current track, it could be modified, or naval officials will drop a new design. Mabus tells me he is extremely happy with the work Austell has done on the LCSs. He thinks the LCS just needs a few tweaks.
This is not unusual. This is not anything out of the ordinary. We do it on every single ship type we have in the Navy. And what we do is we look at requirements, we look at lethality, we look at survivability, we look at what this ship is supposed to do, and does it meet the requirements.
Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel has recently said before Congress that he's not confident the LCSs meet those requirements. And Austell USA's President Craig Percy Avail admits that does worry him. But he says he's going to keep his some 4,000 employees working at their optimal performance.
And again, as long as we perform well and we have a good product, which is what we do, then we feel that'll put us in a competitive advantage going forward, and that's all we can do.
Reporting in Mobile, Katie Weiss, Fox 10 News.
Austell's president says about 2,500 workers were involved in building the USS Alabama.